Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about PPP, the purchasing power parity. Do you know India ranked 3rd on the basis of purchasing power parity in the world, whereas India ranked 5th on the basis of GDP in the world? So exactly what is PPP here, purchasing power parity? This topic is having the high relevance in your prelims examination. In year 2019, there was a very simple question asked on the PPP. The question was, the India ranked 5th on the basis of purchasing power parity, and the definition of purchasing power parity was given in two statements. Watch this video till the end so you have a clarity about the purchasing power parity. In the world, we have a few indicators which need to check about the health of the economy. When we discussed the GDP, nominal GDP, real GDP, and this is the now the PPP on the basis of purchasing power parity. As the name suggests, P for purchasing, we are going to buy something. Power is the power of currency, how much we can buy from the same currency, and the parity, what is the difference between the currency of the two economy. So this is the purchasing power parity. In purchasing power parity, we compare the standard of living of economy as well as the productivity of the different economy. Here we calculate all the things on the basis of a basket of goods, what we can purchase in a real amount of money. Take an example. You are visiting to McDonald's to buy a burger. In USA, the McBurger is costing you $2, where the value of $2 is 160 rupees. And in India, the same burger is costing you 80 rupees. So the same burger we can buy in India in 80 rupees, and the same burger in USA we are buying in 160 rupees. So in the real term, what is the value of Indian rupee as compared to the USA? On the basis of market term, $1 is equal to 80 rupees. But in the case of buying anything, when I'm buying the burger, so that's the rate, original rate. I am buying the burger in 80 rupee in India and the 160 rupee in USA. So the original rate on the basis of purchasing power is 40 rupee $1. So that is the difference on the basis of purchasing power parity. And this is the reason why India ranked 3rd on the basis of purchasing power parity in the world. In purchasing power parity exchange, we convert the currency of one nation into the currency of another nation to buy a particular basket of products. So we can compare the currency of the two country as well as the purchasing power of the one currency with comparison to the another currency. So this is a real indicator which can tell us about the health of the economy and how much we can buy from the currency of the one country to the currency of the another country. But there is some dispute here. There is some of the limitation on the basis of purchasing power parity. There is some argument related to it. The first argument, it is not include the tax, as the tax levied by the different governments are different. It is not include the transportation cost. The transportation cost at a different location is different. It is not mentioned in the government policy. So there are some of the dispute limitation related to the purchasing power parity. But on the basis of the real term, it gives a complete idea about the currency and about its purchase. So whenever we are going to find out the purchasing power parity of a currency, so we can write out S is equal to P1 divided by P2, where the P1 is the price in the first country, P2 is the price in the second country, and S is the comparison between two currency. So we can calculate the purchasing power parity here. So this was the concept of purchasing power parity, and this is useful in your prelims examination as well as in the mains examination. This concept will help you to eliminate the different kind of statements in your question. So be ready for the next video. I will meet you soon with the next video. Thank you. Thank you everyone.